Now we are going to calculate the air fuel ratio of a simple carburetor. AFR ratio of simple carburetor. To calculate this air fuel ratio, we need to consider the steady flow energy equation. Because first of all, we will consider the fluid flowing through carburetor or air flowing through carburetor is compressible. That's why we will use that steady flow energy equation. Steady flow energy equation says that enthalpy at state 1 plus half m v1 square, that means velocity at v1 is velocity at state 1 plus mg z1. Z1 is datum height of state 1 plus heat input equal to enthalpy at state 2 plus half m v2 square, v2 is the velocity at state 2 plus mg z2, z2 is datum height of state 2 for point 2 plus work output from the system. Now we are applying this steady flow energy equation to section AA and BB of, assuming you need mass flow of air, that means m will be 1 for that case, and suppose this one is the carburetor diagram of carburetor, we will apply this equation between section AA and section BB. So here we will consider that there will be adiabatic flow through the carburetor, that's why Q will be equal to 0, and no work transfer during this process, that means carburetor does not need any type of work input or output, so W will be 0. So basically there is the heat and work transfer from intense throat, and H is the A stand for enthalpy and V is velocity. Now, after considering this, this steady flow energy equation will be reduced to half m V1 square. One thing again we have to consider that at state 1 or section A, we consider state 1, point 1. At state 1, this velocity of air will be equal to 0. That means V1 equal to 0. So this part will be 0. This part will be 0. And there is no datum difference in point 1 and 2 according to horizontally placed carburetor. If we place this carburetor like this, generally carburetor placed like horizontally, so there will be no datum difference between state 1 and state 2, point 1 and point 2. So these two will be cancel out. Work transfer will be 0. So this steady flow energy equation will becomes half m v2 square equal to H1 minus H2. Now we have considered mass of air flow equal to 1. So this will become 1. So V2 square will be equal to 2 of H1 minus H2. Now V2 will be equal to root over 2 H1 minus H2. Now, assuming air to behave like ideal gas, assuming air is an ideal gas, we can write H equal to enthalpy equal to Cp into T is a function of temperature, specific heat at constant pressure into T. We can write this. So, instead of H1 and H2, we can write root over of 2 Cp. Cp will be common out, T1 minus T2. Temperature at state 1 and minus temperature state 2. Now, as the flow process from inlet to the venturi throat can be considered to be isentropic, the flow can be considered isentropic. So for isentropic process, we can apply between state 1 and 2. So PB to the power gamma equal to constant, we can write this. And for any process of an ideal gas, PB equal to RT. Now combining these two things, we will try to make a relationship between P and T. Why P and T? Because there will be only temperature difference in carburetor and pressure difference. Due to that pressure difference, the fuel will be flow inside the carburetor and air fuel mixture will be made. So we are combining these two things. We are replacing this P from this equation. P equal to RT by P. We will put this V over here. So P into RT by P to the power gamma equal to constant. So we can write down T to the power gamma by P to the power gamma minus 1 equal to constant. Or T equal to C into P to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. Now applying this equation between two states 1 and 2. So we can write down T2 by T1 equal to P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So now we can replace this temperature, this T2 temperature in terms of this. So T2 will be equal to T1 into P2 by P1 by gamma minus 1 by gamma. So our V2, that means velocity at state 2, will becomes, replacing the value of T2, 2Cp. T1 will be common out in that case, 1 minus P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. Under root of this thing. Now, we want to calculate the mass flow rate of air. That means m dot a first. So m dot a in that case will be rho 1 A1 C1 or rho 1 A1 V1 equal to rho 2 A2 V2. This is a steady state continuity equation for compressible flow. Now we have assumed velocity at state 1, air velocity at state 1, that means V1 is 0. So we will not use this equation, we will use this equation, this much. Rho 1 A2 V2 to calculate mass flow rate of air. Now, before getting into the calculation of mass flow rate, we need to change this rho 2. Like, we cannot know the density of air at state 2. That's why we replace this in terms of other parameters. Like, we know PB equal to MRT. This was for any gas. And for isentropic process, PB to the power gamma equal to constant. Now mass, if we divided both sides by mass, PB to the power gamma, we are dividing both sides by M to the power gamma by C to the power M to the power gamma. Now mass flow rate is mass of the system is constant between every state of the carburetor. That's why this part will be constant, this whole thing will be constant. So we can write P by rho to the power gamma, M by V is rho, equal to constant. So rho 2 can be replaced like this. Rho 2 can be replaced like this. we can use this equation between isentropic process 1 and 2. So P1 by rho 1 to the power gamma equal to P2 rho 2 to the power gamma. So rho t can be written like this, rho 2 equal to P2 by P1. To the power 1 by gamma into rho 1. Rho 2 can be written like this. So we will replace this rho 2 in terms of this value. Again, we don't know value of rho 1. This rho 1 can be again replaced using this equation. We know PV equal to MRT. We are writing this again. PV equal to MRT. So P by rho equal to RT. So P1 by rho 1 will be equal to RT1. P1 by rho 1 will be equal to RT1. So rho 1 will be equal to P1 by RT1. So rho 1 can be written like this. Rho 1 will be equal to P1 by RT1. Now we will try to calculate this mass flow rate like this. Rho 2 can be replaced by this thing, and rho 1 can be replaced by these things. In terms of rho 1, we will write down P1 by RT1 into P2 by P1 to the power 1 by gamma into A2. Into B2. B2 is, we have calculated the value B2, root over of whole root of 2 CPT1 1 minus P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. This is the value of B2. Now we can rewrite the equation like this. Taking this P2 by P1 within the root and taking out this T1 outside of the root, it can be written like this. This A2 will be as it is, P1 will be as it is, R, and root over of T1 was there, and here only T1 is there. The, these two will be become under root of T1, and this thing will be taken inside. That's why P2 by P1, 2 by gamma will be inside. So 2CP P2 by P1, sorry, rho 2 by P2 by P1, 2 by gamma minus, and 2 by gamma plus gamma minus 1 by gamma. This will become P2 by P1 gamma plus 1 by gamma. Okay. Now we know value of Cp is 1.005 kilojoule per kgk for air. Value of gamma is 1.4 and value of R is 0.287 kilojoule per kgk. Now if we replace this value here in this equation, our equation becomes m dot A 0 point m dot a equal to 0.1562 a2 by p1 root over of t1 whole root p2 by p1 1.43 value of gamma is 1.4 2 by 1.4 is will be 1.43 minus p2 by p1 1.71. Now we can consider to make it simpler, this equation simpler, we can consider these things, this under root thing, as phi. So our equation mass flow rate of air will be equal to 0.1562 a2 p1 by root over t1 into 5 kg per second. This is our mass flow rate calculation. So whatever we have calculated till now is in terms of actual, in terms of theoretically mass flow rate of air. Now in actual case, whatever theoretically will be there, the actual case will be less than theoretical values, because of some friction. There must be some friction in the carburetor wall. So this value will be multiplied by coefficient of discharge of air. So this is our actual mass flow rate of air. We have to multiply this coefficient of discharge of air to get actual mass flow rate of the air. Now, as we know, this is constant, this coefficient of discharge of air is constant for a given carburetor, because for that carburetor the friction will be fixed, of the wall friction will be fixed. So this is constant and this part is also constant. So we can write down m dot a actual is proportionate to, and this area at thought 2 at point 2 is also constant for that given carburetor. This area is constant. So this area is constant also. So we can write down P1 by root over T1 into 5. This was our mass flow rate calculation of air. Now to calculate the air fuel ratio, we need to find out the fuel flow rate also. As we know, fuel is a liquid and which can be considered incompressible. That's why to calculate fuel flow rate, we will apply Bernoulli's equation, because the liquid fuel is incompressible, we can consider incompressible. So applying Bernoulli's equation between two point P1 by rho of fuel in plus by G plus V1 square by 2G plus Z1 equal to P2 by rho of fuel G plus V2 square by 2G plus Z2. We are applying this fuel flow rate between these two points. Say this is point 1 and this is point 2. Between these two points, we are applying this formula, this Bernoulli's equation, to calculate the fuel flow rate, because fuel is an incompressible fluid. Now, this formula can be reduced to like, consider velocity at point 2. Velocity at point 2 is have some velocity, and velocity at point 1, that means here velocity, suppose this is point 1, here velocity is considered nearly equal to 0, because the area is much more. So velocity can be considered at point 1 is 0. So this equation can be rewrite like this: P1 by rho of F, we are multiplying both sides by G, plus Z1 equal to P2 by rho F plus v2 square by 2 plus gz2. gz1, gz2. Again, it can be rewrite like this. V2 square, or we can write to it vf square. We are writing this vf square because already you have written v2 for air calculation. So we are taking vf in this case. So vf square by 2 will be equal to p1 by rho f minus p2 by rho f minus of c will be common out z1 minus z minus of it can be read like this z2 minus z1. So see this z2 minus z1, that means z2 minus determinate at here minus determinant at here is can be written as z. Z2 minus z1 is can be written as z, which will be positive because at point 2 it is height is little bit more. So this equation can be again written like this: vf square equal to 2 into p1 minus p2 by rho f minus gz, and if we remove this root, this will be under root. Now, to calculate mass flow rate of fuel m dot f, this will becomes like af, area of fuel flow line, cf or vf, AVF, ρF, ρF, AVF. Okay, this is density of fuel. This is velocity of fuel flow at point 2. This is air at fuel nozzle. Area of fuel nozzle. And this will become AF will be like this. And rho f can be taken inside, or we are writing this like this: 2 p1 minus p2 by rho f minus cz. And rho f can be taken inside, and it will become rho f square. So this equation becomes f into root over of 2. Rho f, one rho f will be cancelled out, one rho f has been taken inside, and p1 minus p2 minus gz rho f. Our equation will be like this. Here f is the area of cross section of nozzle, and rho f is the density of fuel. Now, this is this equation has been calculated theoretically. So in similarly like air, there will be some restriction, some friction between fuel flow line. So in our actual mass flow rate of fuel will be less than the theoretical mass flow rate. So we need to multiply a coefficient of discharge of fuel in actual case. So actual mass flow rate of fuel will be CDF, coefficient discharge of fuel, AF root over 2 rho F P1 minus P2 minus GZ rho F. This will be our equation. Now we have the value of our mass flow rate of air actual and mass flow rate of fuel actual. We can easily calculate the ratio. Air fuel ratio will be, this ratio will be becomes m dot actual, m dot a actual and m dot f actual. So we'll get the ratio of air fuel in actual case of a carburetor. So this air fuel ratio will become, we know this value of this is 0.1562 CDA A2 P1 phi and root over of T1 by CDF AF root over of 2 rho F P1 minus P2 minus GZ rho of F. This will be our air fuel ratio calculation. We can rewrite this equation like this. This air fuel ratio, we can write this 0.1562 CDA by CDF A2 by AF E1 by phi. This value of phi we have to calculate separately. 2 root T1, we are taking this root over T1 inside this root, rho F P1 minus P2 minus CZ rho F. So this is our calculation of air fuel ratio of a certain carburetor when the air is considered compressible. We can compress the air. Now, if we neglect the air fuel compressibility of air, we will get another type of equation. We will look into that. Now, if you neglect the compressibility of air, if we apply between 0.1 and 2, the Bernoulli's equation we have to apply, the equation will become P1 by rho A plus P1 square by 2 plus Z1G. Z1G equal to P2 by rho A plus V2 square by 2 plus Z2G. Equation will be like this. And we have considered velocity at state 1. That means here at section A, this velocity V1 is equal to 0. And there is no data might difference when the carburetor will be placed horizontally. So these two part will be cancelled out. These two part will be equal actually. And our equation will become V2 square by 2 equal to P1 by rho A minus P2 by rho A. Or V2 will be equal to, in that case, root over of 2 P1 minus P2 by rho A. So m dot a mass flow rate of air will become a2 b2 rho a. We will take this value. This will become a2 into root over of 2 rho a. We are taking this rho a inside p1 minus p2. If we take this rho a inside this bracket, inside this root, it will be rho a square. Here will be rho a square and rho a and rho a square will be cancelled out like this. We are rewriting this to make you understand again. A2, writing the value of B2. Into rho a. We are taking this inside the root. That's why it will become rho a square. This will cancel out and our equation will become this. So this is again our theoretically value. here the calculated value. So again our mass flow rate in actual case we need to multiply with coefficient of discharge of air, and our value becomes like this. Okay, now we have calculated the fuel flow rate, mass flow rate of fuel in terms of incompressibility of fuel. So our equation was this. So now our air fuel ratio, when we consider air is an incompressible fluid, it will become m dot a actual. The value of m dot a in actual case, the value of m dot a of actual case, when we consider both are incompressible, so our air fuel ratio will become CdA by CdF A2 by AF root over of 2PA P1 minus P2, and this thing, this whole thing, 2PF P1 minus P2 minus GZ rho F. This 2 will be cancelled out. Oh, and our equation in simplest way, air fuel ratio, mass flow rate of air will be becomes in actual case, this is in actual case, will become CdF A2 by AF. Whenever we consider this determinant is zero, there is very less determinant between fuel flow at from state 1 to state 2, this 2 point, there is no determinant if you consider. So this part will be 0, and P1 minus P2 will be cancel out, and this will be only rho A by rho F. So this is our equation. We will consider there will be determinant zero, z equal to zero in fuel flow line. So this was our air fuel ratio calculation. Now we have to work out with some numericals. Thank you for today.